Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom,
more than anything,
lived a young
more
maiden,
than life,
a sad young lad,
jewels,
and a childless beggar,
more than life,
with his wife.
More than the moon, I wish the king is giving a festival.
More than life,
I wish to go to the festival.
More than riches,
and the whole,
the cow would give us some milk.
More than anything,
I wish we had a child.
Please help.
I wish to go to the festival.
I wish we had a child.
You wish to go to the festival?
The poor girl's mother had died.
You, Cinderella.
Two daughters of her own.
Look at your nails, look at your dress, people will laugh.
Nevertheless, I still wish to go to the festival and dance before the priest.
All three were beautiful of face, but vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother, well, she was not quite as beautiful. Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I dumped a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you can pick them out again in 2 hours' time, you can go to the ball with us.
Fly, birds, down from the sky, down from the eaves and the leaves and the fields and the castles and ponds. Come, little birds. Oh!
Cinderella. Nice, good, nice, kind, good, nice.
Ah! Not that way! Why?
Sorry.
Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident. Well, at least that's what he thought. He was eager to have a family of his own and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Oh, who might that be?
We stole their last year from bread.
Oh, it's that witch from next door.
We have no bread.
Of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden, and she told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, and nothing but greens, parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and middlefoot, and lettuce. He said all right, but it wasn't quite because I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was warming me, prepping me, working through my rutabaga, writing my arugula, and burping up the brandy and my champion, my favorite. I should have laid his throne right there. I could have turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair, or a snake. To spare. In return, however, I said fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it square.
I had a brother?
No, but you had a sister.
I refused to tell him any more of his sister, not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, and that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had hidden in his pocket? You see, when I had inherited that garden, my mother warned me that I would be punished if I were ever to lose any of the beans.
Beans?
The special beans. I let him go. He didn't know he stole my beans. He was watching them crawl back over the wall. When bang, crash, and the lightning flash, and... Well, that's another story, never mind. Anyways, at last, the big day came. I made my claim. Well, then take away the beans. They shrieked and screamed, but I did. And I knew I shall never be reached. And your father cried. And your mother died from dregs. Strong natural, and that it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not mortified. And I leave it to spell. You two son, that your family tree would always be a barren one. Now there's no more fuss, there's no more scenes. My garden thrives, you should see my nectarines. But I'm telling you the same, I'll tell kings and queens. Don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans.
Now listen to me, Jack. Milky White needs to be taken to market. Fetch the best price you can. Take no less than 5 pounds. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Now how much are you to ask?
No more than 5 pounds.
Less than five.
The hair is yellow as corn. 4, the slipper as pure as gold.
Darling, those nails, darling, those clothes, lentils are popping, but darling, with those, you'd make us the fool of the festival in order to find the prince.
The carriage is waiting.
We must be gone.
Good night, Father.
Look what I found in Father's
night.
Jacket.
6 beans.
Oh, I wonder if they're the...
The witch's beans. We'll take them with us.
Oh, no, you're not coming.
I know you're fearful of the woods at night.
Spells on my house. Only I can lift the spells. Spells on my house.
Spirits here.
a basket.
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something that'll make her strong.
Where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter way further in the woods, past the ends of the three large oak trees.
Look at that flesh. Pink and plump. Hello, little girl. Tender and fresh. Not one lump. Hello, little girl. This one's especially lush. Delicious. Hello, little girl. What's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun won't set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not to delay or beat this land.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first, then Miss Plum. What a delectable couple. Utter perfection. One brittle, one supple. One moment, my dear.
Mother said, not to delay.
Just so, little girl, any path, so many worth exploring. And just one would be so boring. And look what you're ignoring. Think of those crisp, aging bones, then something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your meal.
That defies description.
My mother would.
Why,
ginger or a sack of beets.
How many beets?
Six.
Five. We can't part with all of them. We must save one for ourselves. I'd say they're about a pound each at the very least.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
Possibly. Good luck there. Thanks for the cow. Went after the red cape. As for the little girl, she was surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Oh dear, how uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets.
Good day, grandmother.
My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big eyes you have.
The better to see you, my dear.
But grandmother, what large ears you have.
The better to hear you.
But grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have.
The better to eat you with, my dear.
And so, after the wolf saying what he said, in a single bound, he ate the little girl. Well, it was a full day of eating for both, and with his appetite appeased, he took to bed for a nice long nap.
That grandmother has a mighty snore.
Oh, where's the little one?
Eating, no doubt. Or eaten? Grandmother! Ah! What's that red cloth in the corner of your mouth? Looks to me to be a piece of the cape! The red cape! I'll cut it from within your stomach!
So
dear over there. Excuse me, miss, but have you seen a beautiful young maiden in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I believe I see her over there.
Never lied to royalty before. I've never anything to royalty before. Thank you so much. If the prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide.
Well, what are you doing out here in the woods with a cow?
Oh, my husband's somewhere in the woods. He's undoing a spell.
Oh, a spell?
Oh, yes. Now, the prince, what was he like?
He's a very nice prince.
Yes, and?
It's a very nice ball.
Yes, and?
When I entered, they trumpeted.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
We did nothing but dance.
Yes, and?
And it made a nice change.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
He had charm for a prince, I guess.
Yes?
I don't need a wide range. And it's all very strange.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow week?
Perhaps.
Perhaps? I want to be pursued by the prince. The only thing that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. But I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Would you look over there? Looks like a giant vine growing right next to that cottage.
I mean, slippers?
It looks like a huge beanstalk growing right up into the sky.
I'd say those are as pure as gold.
What in the world?
Those are definitely as pure as gold.
Wife.
But you said I could buy her back.
Well, I
wish to sell any more.
But do you wish more money?
Oh, more money as always.
You stay there with 5 gold pieces and I will go get more.
Wait, come back, I didn't say. 5 gold pieces. Why, with 5 gold pieces, I could buy new baking supplies for a year. I could buy a brand new chimney and a new roof. 5 gold pieces.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When I first appear, I seem delirious. For I explain, I am nothing serious.
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces.
Well, I had not thought to put my rice on it.
Exactly. You haven't thought about many things now, have you, son?
Hey, give me that back. It's not yours.
Nor is it Jack's. The money is not what's important. What is important is that your wish be honored.
Hey, come back here, Dan. Give me that back.
Oh.
What are you doing here?
I see you have the cape.
Yes, I have the cape. Only 2 items left to locate.
3.
2.
You have the cape!
Oh, what have you done with the cow?
She ran away and never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to trust her with you.
She might have easily just run away from you.
But she didn't.
But she might have.
But she didn't.
Who cares? The cow is gone. Get it back. Get it back.
We were just going to do that, honestly. Here, I can give you the cape.
Don't give me that food. I don't want to touch that. Have you no sense? Tomorrow's midnight, deliver the items, or you wish you never thought to have a child.
I don't see that woman.
Sorry I lost the cow.
It's okay. I shouldn't have yelled. No, please. Just go back to the village. I'll make things right. We can go back to our simple and fun life. No more hunting in the woods for strange objects. No more stupid boys, stupid girls, no more witches. Please, go. Go!
Agony far more painful than yours.
know she would go with you if there only were doors. Agony, oh, the torches they teach. For what's as intriguing or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne you are everything maidens could wish for?
Then
why no,
that girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there, and you're nearing her all the while hearing that.
Go. play the fool and...
Oh, you mean that maiden in the ball gown? She went in that direction. I was trying to hold her here for you.
I can capture my own damsel, thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
Where did he go?
Who?
The Prince of Court.
Yes!
Oh, he went in that direction, but you'll never reach them.
We would have if that mongrel with the cow had a blessed eye.
Cow?
Please, let me compare this color with that of your own.
He was the cow.
What are you doing here?
You've the cape.
Yes, I have the cape and the cow. Only two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three, compare this to your corn.
Where did you find it?
Pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Oh, we have one entire day left. Surely we'll locate that slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well, perhaps I'll take the two of us to get this child.
You've changed your dairy, your different in the woods. More shore, more sherry, you're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted than I knew you to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough, it's not true. It takes two of us who came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us. It takes care, it takes patience and fear and despair to change. Though you swear to change, who can tell if you do? It takes two.
You change your thriving.
Magic.
Not with the brain larger than this is gonna believe their magic.
And steal it.
It was just 2 days ago you were accusing me of deceit in securing the cow.
Then don't steal it and resign yourself to a childless life.
How about you go for the cow? For I found a maiden in these woods these past eves, and I'm pretty sure I can obtain one of her gold slippers.
Fine.
Fine.
That's simply...
Fine!
Okay. Rapunzel.
No! No!
The witch discovered her affections for the prince before he could spirit her away.
What did I clearly say? Children should listen.
No, no, please!
What were you not to do? Children must see and learn. Why could you not obey? Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince. Oh, but I am wrong. I am ugly. I embarrass you.
No.
You are ashamed of me.
No.
You are ashamed. You don't understand.
It was lonely to have that power.
I was not company enough.
I'm no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
And as he leapt from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes, and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival.
Give her a slipper and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old man?
when I first appear, I seem deleterious.
Shut up! Do as he says! He's obviously some spirit or something besides me. Only need the one.
Yes.
He began a
slipper. And as he came to Cinderella's house, Cinderella's stepmother took the slipper into Lucinda's room. Joined the prince on his horse, riding off to become his bride.
Thank you.
kingdoms were filled with joy, and those who deserved to were certain to live a long and happy life.
Thank you.